فَإِنْ وَقَعَ مَا يُوهِمُ التَّعَارُضُ فِي فَهْمِكَ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ هَذَا لَيْسَ بِحَسَبِ النَّصِ. Oh, so if something that appears to be contradicting in your understanding comes to you, know that this is not as per the textual evidence, وَلَكِنْ بِاعْتِبَارِ مَا عِنْدِكَ, rather that is an issue that you have. In your understanding, they are contradictory, while in essence, they are not contradictory. So, in your understanding, Ya'juj and Ma'juj cannot possibly behind a wall until now, because Google Earth has already exposed the whole dunya to us. In your understanding, it doesn't enter your tiny mukh. For the rest of us, that's revelation, and we don't got a problem with that. Nobody got a problem. No Muslim in his right mind has a problem with that. So, don't say that there's a problematic issue with the hadith, or they're bizarre. The bizarreness and the problem is in your brain. All right. So, and that is just not just that fellow. Any one of us, ya akhwan and akhawat, you, me, wallah, wallah al-azim, if you come across something that you're not understanding, accuse your brain. And I will do it anytime. I'll say, I just don't understand. I have a problem in not understanding, but I submit to Allah. I surrender to Allah. I believe in what Allah revealed. I believe what Prophet ﷺ taught. I'm an unintelligent person. My intelligence is not at the level for me to understand it. It doesn't mean that it's wrong. And this is the problem we have. When someone thinks he's so intelligent that it has to make sense to him, and if it doesn't make sense, there's a problem with it, then that's a problem right there. Oh, but people say, man, you know, he's a nice guy. Yeah, well, a nice guy is not going to take you to Jannah. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way He deserves to be praised, and we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace and send His blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. I have a question for you. Can you please tell me in the chat box or in the comments, even though I'm not going to check it right now, I will check it later, what are the two subject matters that we have covered, or if there's more, tell me more, that we have covered thus far in terms of what Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah do not do. Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah believe in what Allah described Himself with, they believe in what Prophet ﷺ described Allah with, and they do so without واحد اثنين ثلاثة أربعة. Without 1, 2, 3, 4, we've already covered 1 and 2. Do you remember what they are? Share with me the information, and I want to make sure that you're familiar with the Arabic or with the Arabi. As the brother says, I'm trying to remember his name right now. Hey, he doesn't like the word Arabic. He says they try to westernize the al-kalima arabiya. Tell me what you know. Ala kulli hal, we were discussing in our last session, I'm just scrolling up to give you a little background. We stopped at the statement, فَأَنْتَ يَا أَخِي عَلَيْكَ فِي هَذَا الْبَابِ بِالتَّسْلِيمِ. The Shaykh, rahimahullah, said, as for you, my brother, then upon you in regards to the subject matter is to surrender. Surrender. فَمِنْ تَمَامِ الْإِسْلَامِ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أَلَّا تَبْحَثَ فِي هَذِهِ الْأُمُورِ. Sorry. By the way, people that believe in all of these Illuminati and the secret societies and all that stuff, the conspiracy theories, they show you like all these videos of people who are going like this, and then they say that this is evidence that they're, you know, devil worshippers and whatever. And while this is definitely a sign of devil worshippers, you have to realize that sometimes people do this innocently. You know what I'm saying? Like you just go like this, and then your pinky naturally is another finger that is erected along with your index. This does not mean right now that if you're doing this that you're automatically one of those people and you're one of the C6 secret societies and all, you build a whole story. I remember some sister had sent me all these emails about, you know, one of these speakers, actually, I don't want to mention his name, that he's definitely of them, and she showed me all these clips where he was making like certain signs with his hands. And as much as deviant as this person, actually, we disagree with them in totality, I still said, sister, I think you're just like really reading into the matter a little bit too much. So I'm just mentioning this out there. You have to understand sometimes the hand gestures are a natural behavior. على كل حال, the Shaykh said, Allah تبحث في هذه الأمور. So from the perfection of your Islam to Allah Azza wa Jal, from the perfection of your surrendering and submission to Allah, is that you don't actually delve into these matters. ولهذا أحذركم دائما من البحث فيما يتعلق بأسماء الله وصفاته على سبيل التعنت والتنطع والشيء الذي ما سأل الصحابة عنه. That's why I warn you, the Shaykh saying, I warn you always not to delve into the matters of the names and attributes of Allah in a manner in which you're being too extreme, in a manner of extremism, and in that stubborn, with a stubborn approach, and delving into matters that the Sahaba did not ask about. لأننا إذا فتحنا على أنفسنا هذه الأبواب, because if we open upon ourselves these doors, انفتحت علينا الأبواب. يا شيخ, turn off the camera, بارك الله فيك. الحمد لله, brothers are dressed when they suddenly turn on the camera. انفتحت علينا الأبواب, suddenly the doors will be open up against us. وتهدمت الأسوار, and all the barriers will be demolished. وعجزنا عن ضبط أنفسنا, and we will be unable to control ourselves. فلذلك قل, that's why we say, that's why you should say, سمعنا وأطعنا وآمنا وصدقنا. You should say, we hear and we obey and we believe and we trust. آمنا وصدقنا بالخبر, we believe and we trust the information. وأطعنا الطلب, and we obeyed the command. وسمعنا القول, and we heard the textual evidence. حتى تسلم, until you are safe. So what is the Shaykh saying here? He's not saying that you shouldn't learn these subject matters, because obviously he's teaching you the subject matter. What he's saying is people that want to go and discuss matters that were deliberately not discussed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba, to have a conversation that they didn't have in these matters, is what you're being warned against. Because if you open up that door, then the shaitan will bring about all types of ideas and whispers to you, and then you will really trouble yourself when there's absolutely no reason to trouble. This is a matter where you have to use your faith to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whatever information you receive, you believe in that, and you have a peace of mind in regards to who Allah Azza wa Jal is. وأي إنسان يسأل فيما يتعلق بصفات الله عن شيء ما سأل عنه الصحابة فقل كما قال الإمام مالك فإن لك سلفا. The Shaykh said, any person who asks anything about the attributes of Allah which the Sahaba did not ask about, then you say to them, like Imam Malik said to them. Say to them, like Imam Malik said to them back then. Verily, you have a predecessor in that. You have a Salaf in that. You have someone from the Salaf who preceded you in that. السؤال عن هذا بدعة. Say to him, this question, أخي, is an innovation. وإذا قلت ذلك لن يلح عليك. Because if you say that, he will not be persistent. وإذا ألح, and if he becomes persistent, فقل يا مبتدع. Ya innovator, oh innovator, السؤال عنه بدعة. I'm telling you, the asking about the subject matter is an innovation. اسأل عن الأحكام التي أنت مكلف بها. Ask about the rulings that are incumbent on you. أما أن تسأل عن شيء يتعلق بالرب عز وجل وبأسمائه وصفاته ولم يسأل عنه الصحابة فهذا لا نقبله منك أبدا. As for you to ask about matters pertaining to the Lord and to His names and attributes, that which the Sahaba never asked about, that we will never allow you. We will never approve. We will never accept that from you. We will never accept that from you. وهناك كلام للسلف يدل على أنهم يفهمون معاني ما أنزل الله على رسوله من الصفات. And also we have some predecessor, we have some statements of the Salaf that are reported to us that indicate that they used to understand the meanings of the attributes which Allah Azza wa Jal spoke about and sent down upon His Messenger. كما نقل عن الأوزاعي وغيره, as it was narrated from Al-Awza'i. ونقل عنهم أنهم قالوا في آيات الصفات وأحاديث, it was narrated to us that they said in regards to the ayat that were speaking about the attributes of Allah and also the narrations from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam which were speaking about the attributes of Allah, أمروها كما جاءت بلا كيف. Stick to the apparent meaning without mentioning how. أمروها كما جاءت, أو أمروها كما جاءت, take it as it came without mentioning how. وهذا يدل على أنهم يثبتون لها معنى من وجهين. This proves that they actually affirm the meaning from two different angles. أولا أنهم قالوا أمروها كما جاءت. The first, the fact that they said stick to the apparent meaning as it came to you. ومعلوم أنها ألفاظ جاءت لمعاني. And no doubt the terms came as a packaging for the meaning. ولم تأتي عبثا. It wasn't just some fooling around. فإذا أمرناها كما جاءت. So if we stick to it as it came, لزم من ذلك أن نثبت لها معنى. Then we are necessitated to actually confirm a meaning behind it. Meaning it couldn't have been meaningless, and then they will say, stick to it as it came. ثانيا قولهم بلا كيف. As for the statement بلا كيف, without mentioning the how or the manner. لأن نفي الكيفية يدل على وجود أصل المعنى. Because denying the how actually proves that the origin of the meaning. It proves the origin of the meaning. لأن نفي الكيفية عن الشيء لا يوجد لغو وعبث. Because to deny the manner of something cannot be there just for entertainment and fun. Meaning you only say, I'm not going to tell you how when there's an original meaning that is already there. You understand? So the Shaykh is trying to prove that there is an original meaning. And that's why they said, accept the original meaning and only don't discuss the how. Because that's what you don't have any information about. So no one can say that we don't have an actual meaning anymore because they said accept it as it came. No. The fact that they said accept it as it came, it proves that there was a meaning, but they were trying to tell you the how aspect of the meaning. That's what is not your business, and don't delve into it and don't speak about it. ثانيا نعم. إذن فهذا الكلام المشهور عند السلف يدل على أنهم يثبتون لهذه النصوص معنى. So this popular statements attributed to the Salaf proves that they used to affirm the actual meaning behind the texts. أي طيب. ولا تمثيل. أهل السنة والجماعة, they don't have tamtheel. Tell me, brothers and sisters, I told you in a previous class that some of these words have a modern contemporary meaning. And I told you that takif means air conditioning. And I told you that tamtheel means something else. Which one of the bright brothers and sisters remembers what tamtheel means in modern language? And how it is not what we're talking about in any way, shape, or form. Did anyone answer? Yeah. All right. What did they say? Acting. Very good. MashaAllah, Tabarak al-Rahman. Today they say, Al-Mumathil Al-Kabir Juju Majuju Bangaluju Fahuju. The great actor, Mumathil. And they say this is Timthiliya. Timthiliya is a play. When you actually go to a play. And so the term, contemporary speaking, has a completely different meaning from the historical original Arabic text. And the term in its generic form means the likening, but of course we have the legislative technical meaning from a theological point of view. And so that's what we will address right now. وَلَا تَمْثِيلْ يَعْنِي وَمِنْ غَيْرِ تَمْثِيلْ. Meaning we don't do tamthil. فَأَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ يَتَبَرَّؤُونَ مِنْ تَمْثِيلِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ بِخَلْقِهِ لَا فِي ذَاتِهِ ولا في صفاته. Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah, they declare their innocence from likening Allah to His creation. Neither in Allah's essence nor in Allah's attributes, whether it is the Allah Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala or Allah's attributes, we don't liken Allah to His creation in any way, shape, or form for all purposes and intents. إذن نعم والتمثيل ذكر مماثل مماثل ذكر مماثل للشيء. What does تمثيل mean? It is to mention something which is similar to something else. Mentioning the similarity to something else. وبينه وبين التكييف عموم وخصوص مطلق. And there's a relationship between likening and mentioning how. And that relationship could be general and it could be specific. لأن كل ممثل مكيف وليس كل مكيف ممثلا. Hey. وليس كل مكيف ممثلا. لأن كل ممثل مكيف وليس كل مكيف ممثلا. Every person who likens Allah to His creation is actually falling into the manner or the how, but not everyone who speaks about the manner or the how is actually falling into likening Allah to His creation. Do you understand? I hope so. Right. Just like you say, كُلُّ نَبِيٍ كُلُّ رَسُولٌ نَبِيٍ وليس كل نبي رسول. Every messenger is a prophet because the prophethood is a level below messengership. So you cannot be a messenger until you're a prophet first. But not every prophet is a messenger. Like Adam عليه السلام was a prophet, but he didn't reach the level of messengership. So every messenger must be a prophet first, but not every prophet is a messenger. You understand what I'm saying? Every doctor is a graduate, I'm hoping. If you're a doctor, you haven't graduated from school, then that, please quit like right now. But not every graduate is a doctor. Capish? طيب. لأن التكييف ذكر كيفية غير مقرونة بمماثل. Okay. تكييف is mentioning the how without linking it to a similarity. مثل أن تقول, such as you saying, لي قلم. كيفيته كذا وكذا. I have a pen which has such and such traits or qualities. فإن قرنت بمماثل صار تمثيلا. If you now liken it to another similar pen, then you become a likener. A person who's likening Allah Azza wa Jal to His creation. You become a person who's striking these kind of similarity. You fall into تمثيل. مثل أن تقول, مثل أن أقول هذا القلم, مثل هذا القلم. Such as me saying this pen is like that pen. لأني ذكرت شيئا مماثلا للشيء, because I've mentioned something that is similar to another thing. وعرفت هذا القلم بذكر مماثله, and I only got to know this pen by mentioning something that is similar to it, by mentioning the similarity it has with another pen. وأهل السنة والجماعة يثبتون لله عز وجل الصفات بدون مماثلة. And the people of Sunnah and Jama'ah, they affirm to Allah Azza wa Jal the attributes without any likening. يقولون إن الله عز وجل له حياة وليست مثل حياتنا. They say Allah Azza wa Jal has a life and it is unlike our lives. له علم وليس مثل علمنا. Allah has knowledge and it is unlike our knowledge. له بصر وليس مثل بصرنا. He has sight and it is unlike our sight. له وجه وليس مثل وجوهنا. He has a face and it is unlike our faces. له يد وليست مثل أيدينا. He has a hand and it is unlike our hands. وهكذا جميع الصفات. And similarly we say in regards to all of the attributes. يقولون إن الله عز وجل لا يماثل خلقه فيما وصف به نفسه أبدا. They say Allah Azza wa Jal does not resemble His creation in anything which He described Himself with ever. وَلَهُمْ عَلَى ذَلِكَ أَدِلَّةٍ سَمْعِيَّةٍ وَأَدِلَّةٍ عَقْلِيَّةٍ. And to support them in that, they have textual evidence and they have rational evidences. So what are those textual and rational evidences? الْأَدِلَّةُ السَّمْعِيَّةُ تَنْقَسِمُ إِلَى قِسْمَيْنِ خَبَرْ وَطَلَبْ. The textual evidences are divided into two parts. Khabar is declarative, وَطَلَبْ is imperative. All right, let me take a sip. Bismillah. It is imperative, declarative, and imperative. I hope you know English. Because if you know English, you know that there are four types of sentences. Declarative sentences, imperative sentences, interrogative sentences, and exclamatory sentences. Or maybe you don't. No problemo. فمن الخبر قوله قوله تعالى فمن الخبر قوله تعالى ليس كمثلي شيء. An example of declarative is the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, there's nothing like unto him. فالآية فيها نفي صريح للتمثيل. This ayah has a clear negation of likening Allah to his creation. It has a clear negation and refutation against تمثيل. نعم. فإن وقول وقول وقوله هل تعلم له سمية. Do you know anything that is similar to him? Do you know of any who is similar to him? فإن هذا وإن كان إن شاء لكنه بمعنى الخبر. This particular ayah, even though it's coming in this form, it is still linguistically, of course, it is still a declarative sentence. لأنه استفهام بمعنى نفي, because it's an interrogative sentence that came with the intent of negation. Do you know anyone like him? Meaning there is no one like him. Just like Allah says in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَلَ مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. Who is better in speech than he who calls to Allah? The ayah actually means no one is better in speech than he who calls to Allah. In modern day language, you could say in your office, who is better in Excel than me? And you're basically saying, no one is better in Excel than me. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is a linguistic aspect where, from an articulation point of view, you ask a question, but your intent is to confirm or negate something. نعم. وقوله ولم يكن له وقوله عفوا ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. And there's nothing like unto him, and there's nothing co-equal or comparable unto him. فهذه كلها كلها تدل أو فهذه كلها تدل فهذه كلها تدل على نفي المماثلة وهي كلها خبرية. All of these evidences are negating مماثلة, تمثيل, and all of them are declarative in nature. As for imperative, وأما الطلب فقال الله تعالى فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا. As for the imperative, Allah says, so do not make rivals with Allah. Do not set up rivals with Allah. أي نظراء مماثلين, meaning those that are equal and rivals. وقال فلا تضربوا لله الأمثال. Do not strike the similitudes to Allah, meaning don't give a similitude where you liken Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his creation. فَمَنْ مَثَّلَ اللَّهَ بِخَلْقِهِ فَقَدْ كَذَّبَ الْخَبَرُ وَعَصَى الْأَمْرُ. So whosoever likens Allah to his creation has belied the information, the declarative, وَعَصَى الْأَمْرُ, and he has disobeyed the imperative. وَلِهَذَا أَطْلَقَ بَعْضُ السَّلَفِ الْقَوْلَ بِالتَّكْفِيرِ لِمَنْ مَثَّلَ اللَّهَ بِخَلْقِهِ. That's why some of the scholars, they declared takfir. Some of the Salaf declared takfir on the one who likens Allah to his creation. فقال نعيم ابن حماد الخزاعي شيخ البخاري رحمه الله. So Imam al-Khuza'i, the Shaykh of Bukhari, said, may Allah have mercy on him, من شبه الله بخلقه فقد كفر. Whosoever likens Allah to his creation has committed disbelief. He has disbelieved. لأنه جمع بين التكذيب بالخبر وعصيان الطلب. Because he brought a relation between denying and belying the declarative, which is the Quran. He's denying the textual evidence and he's also disobeying the command or the imperative where Allah Azza wa Jal said, فَلَا تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا. Do not make equals with Allah. Do not set up rivals with Allah. وَأَمَّا الْأَدِلَّةُ الْعَقْلِيَّةُ عَلَى انْتِفَاءِ التَّمَاثُلِ بَيْنَ الْخَالِقِ وَالْمَخْلُوقِ فَمِنْ وُجُوهِ. As for the rational intellectual evidences that negate the similarity between the creator and the creation, then we have a number of angles. أَوَّلًا أن نقول, first we say, لا يمكن التماثل بين الخالق والمخلوق بأي حال من الأحوال. There is no way that there will ever be a similarity between the creator and the creation in any condition under any circumstance. لو لم يكن بينهما من التباين إلا أصل الوجود لكان كافيا. Had there been nothing in terms of the vast difference between them except the very essence of their existence, then that would have been sufficient. وذلك أن وجود الخالق واجب فهو أزلي أبدي. That's because the existence of the creator is compulsory and it is ageless and eternal. ووجود المخلوق ممكن مسبوق بعدم ويلحقه فناء. As for the existence of the creation, then it is possible and it is preceded with non-existence and it will be met with perishment. فما كان كذلك لا يمكن أن يقال إنهما متماثلان. Any two things that are of that nature, you can never say they are similar. The very existence of Allah is eternal and ageless, and the very existence of the creation is possible and was preceded by non-existence and will come to perish at some point. So the very essence of the two are not alike. So what in the world are you likening them to each other? Why would you liken Allah to His creation or liken us to Allah Azza wa Jal when the very essence of the existence, there's absolutely no similarity between them? ثانيا أن نجد التباين العظيم بين الخالق والمخلوق في صفاته وأفعاله. يا أخي, we find this vast, tremendous distinction between the creator and the creation and their attributes and their actions. في صفاته يسمع عز وجل كل صوت مهما خفي ومهما بعد. In regards to hearing, Allah Azza wa Jal hears every sound no matter how small and how far it is. No matter how hidden and how deep it is. لو كان في قعار البحار. Even if it were to be in the deepest of the oceans and the seas. لسمعه عز وجل. Allah عز وجل will hear it. Even that tiny little creature at the bottom of the deepest sea, if it's moving in the sand, Allah hears it, Allah sees it, Allah knows about it. Your hearing is as good as it gets, a wall maybe. All you need is a wall or someone to stuff two cottons in your ear and you're deaf. على طول. Hey, يا بني آدم, وأنزل الله قوله تعالى قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها وتشتكي إلى الله والله يسمع تحاوركما إن الله سميع بصير. Indeed, Allah has heard the statement of her that disputes with you concerning her husband and complains to Allah. Allah hears the arguments between you both. Verily, Allah is all hearer, all seer. تقول عائشة الحمد لله الذي وسع سمعه الأصوات. All praises due to Allah whose hearing encompasses all sounds. إني لفي الحجرة. Verily, I am in the chamber. وإنه ليخفى علي بعض حديثها. And verily, I'm unable to hear part of her conversation. I'm unable to hear and I'm right there in the same chamber. والله تعالى سمعها من على عرشه. And Allah عز وجل heard her while He's over her throne. وَبَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهَا مَا لَا يَعْلَمُ مَدَاهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. And the distance between her and Allah is that which only Allah Azza wa Jal knows. The distance between them is something that only Allah Azza wa Jal knows. وَلَا يُمْكِنْ أَنْ يَقُولُ قَائِلٌ إِنَّ سَمَعَ اللَّهِ مِثْلَ سَمْعِنَا. Therefore, no person can say that the hearing of Allah is like our hearing. Hey, now, interestingly, you have Aisha saying that Allah Azza wa Jal, يعني Subhanallah, and the people don't understand. Hey, طيب, ثالثاً, the third subject matter, نقول نحن نعلم أن الله تعالى مبين الخلق بذاته. We know that Allah Azza wa Jal, we know that Allah Azza wa Jal is distinct from His creation in His essence. وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. Verily, His kursi extends over the heavens and the earth. والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة. And on the day of resurrection, the whole of the earth will be grasped by His hand. ولا يمكن لأحد من الخلق أن يكون هكذا. And no one among the creation of Allah can ever be like that. فإذا كان مبينا الخلق في ذاته. So if Allah عز وجل is distinct from His creation in His very essence, فالصفات تابعة للذات. Then the attributes are actually follow the essence. The attributes will take the same ruling as the essence. Therefore, you can never draw that comparison. فيكون أيضا مبين الخلق في صفاته عز وجل. So Allah عز وجل is also unlike His creation in His attributes. Just like the essence of Allah is unlike His creation, therefore the attributes of Allah are unlike His creation. ولا يمكن التماثل بين الخالق والمخلوق. And there can never be any similarity or comparison between the Creator and the created. رابعا نقول إننا نشاهد في المخلوقات أشياء أو أشياء تتفق في الأسماء وتختلف في المسميات. We see among the creation of Allah, we witness a lot of things that are same in their name, but they're different. But different in what is named. يختلف الناس في صفاتهم. The people vary in their attributes. هذا قوي البصر وهذا ضعيفه. This person have a strong vision. That person has a weak vision. وَهَذَا قَوِيُّ السَّمْعِ وَهَذَا ضَعِيفٌ. This person has strong hearing and that other person is weak in his hearing. هَذَا قَوِيُّ الْبَدَنِ وَهَذَا ضَعِيفٌ. This person is strong in his physical build and that person is weak. وَهَذَا ذَكَرٌ وَهَذِي أُنْثَى. This person is a male and that other person is a female. Back when it was only males and females. Now, with the LGBTQERSTUVWYZ, you have all types of human beings. Someone showed a video on Facebook, in one of these gay parades. A dude walking with two human beings acting like dogs, crawling on their hands or feet. It's a disturbing, you shouldn't look for it because it has some imagery that is not permissible, but that's what fell on my eyes when I saw the post. And you only wonder, ya akhi, what do these humans want? You know, these transgenders and those people that they say, I identify as this gender or that gender. And that's the biggest argument against the liberalists and those people that want to, you know, give everybody the freedom to be whatever they want. At some point, that freedom is going to infringe on their freedom and then they're going to change their mind. Otherwise, I mean, if a man enters a woman's bathroom and says, I'm sorry, I identify as a woman, and then you technically, if you want to preserve his right, you have to let him go into the woman's bathroom. Do you understand what's going on here? I mean, I don't want to go on tangent right now and go off the topic, even though that requires a lecture of its own. Ala kulli hal, we've spoken about this, we need to speak about it some more. Hey, na'am. وَهَكَذَا التَّبَايُنُ فِي الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ الَّتِي مِنْ جِنْسٍ وَاحِدٍ. Similarly, we see that vast distinction among the creation which belong to one species. فَمَا بَالُكَ بِالْمَخْلُوقَاتِ الْمُخْتَلِفَةِ الْأَجْنَاسِ. Then what about the various species? among the creation, humans with animals and plants and so on and so forth. فَالتَّبَايُنْ بَيْنَهَا أَظْهَرُ. So that distinction between them is even more evident. وَلِهَذَا لَا يُمْكِنْ لِأَحَدٍ أَنْ يَقُولْ إِنَّ لِي يَدًا كَيَدِ الْجَمَلِ. That's why no one can ever say, I have a hand like the hand of a camel. أَوْ لِي يَدًا كَيَدِ الذَّرَّةِ. Or I have a hand like the hand of an atom. أَوْ لِي يَدًا كَيَدِ الْهِرِ. Or I have a hand like a cat. فَعِندَنَا الْآنْ إِنسَانْ وَجَمَلْ وَذَرَّةِ وَهِرِ. We have right now a human, a camel, an atom, or an ant, by the way. Dharra actually also means ant. And in this context, it probably means ant. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. The scholars say the dharra is a modern term from atom, but the actual original meaning back then was an ant. So we have a human, a camel, an ant, and a cat. كُلُّ وَاحِدْ لَهُ يَدْ مُخْتَلِفَ عَنِ الثَّانِ. Each one has a hand that is unlike the other. مَعَ أَنَّهَا مُتَّفِقَةٌ فِي الْإِسْمِ. Even though they all have the same name. It's all in agreement. They all have the same name. You have hand, 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 hand. You use the term hand four times. فَنَقُولْ إِذَا جَازَ التَّفَاوُتُ بَيْنَ الْمُسَمَّيَاتِ فِي الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ مَعَ اتِّفَاقِ الْإِسْمِ. If it is permissible then, if it's possible, that we'll have this huge distinction in what is being named among the creation, even though we agree on the name itself. فَجَوَازُهُ بَيْنَ الْخَالِقِ وَالْمَخْلُوقِ مِنْ بَابِ أَوْلَى. So that distinction to be there between the creator and the creation is more deserving and more entitled to and more rightful. بَلْ نَحْنُ نَقُولُ. Rather we will say, إِنَّ التَّفَاوُتَ بَيْنَ الْخَالِقِ وَالْمَخْلُوقِ لَيْسَ جَائِزًا فَقَدْ بَلْ هُوَ وَاجِبُ. Rather we say, the distinction between the creator and the creation is not merely a possibility, rather it is a necessity and an obligation. فَعِنْدَنَا أَرْبَعَةُ وُجُوهٍ عَقْلِيَّةٍ كُلُّهَا تَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْخَالِقَ لَا يُمْكِنُ أَنْ يُمَاثِلَ الْمَخْلُوقَ بِأَيِّ حَالٍ مِنَ الْأَحْوَالِ. So we have four different angles of intellectual and rational nature through which we have the evidence that the creator can never ever be likened to his creation under any circumstance. ربما نقول أيضا. Let us add another one, and perhaps you will say, هناك دليل فطري. There's also a natural inclination evidence, a natural disposition based evidence. وَذَلِكَ لِأَنَّ الْإِنسَانَ بِفِطْرَتِهِ بِدُونِ أَنْ يُلَقَّنْ يَعْرِفَ الْفَرْقَ بَيْنَ الْخَالِقِ وَالْمَخْلُوقِ. The human being, upon his natural disposition, without being taught anything, knows the distinction between the creator and the creation. وَلَوْلَا هَذِهِ الْفِطْرَةَ مَا ذَهَبَ يَدْعُو الْخَالِقِ. Had it not been for that distinction, that natural disposition, he would not have called on the creator. Because he knows it. He calls on Allah because he knows that Allah is unlike him. Otherwise, he would have called on another human being. فَتَبَيَّنَ الْآنْ أَنَّ التَّمْثِيلَ مُنْتَفٍ سَمْعًا وَعَقْلًا وَفِطْرَةً. So now it is clear that likening is negated and prohibited textually, intellectually, and from a natural disposition point of view. فإن قال قائل إن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حدثنا بأحاديث تشتبه علينا. If a person were to come and say, verily the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke to us in certain narrations with things that are confusing to us. هل هي تمثيل أو غير تمثيل. Is it a form of likening Allah to his creation or is it not? وَنَحْنُ نَضَعْهَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيكُمْ. And we will present it to you. قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّكُمْ سَتَرَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ كَمَا تَرَوْنَ الْقَمَرَ لَيْلَةَ الْبَدْرِ لَا تُضَامُونَ فِي رُؤْيَتِهِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, you shall definitely see your Lord as you see the moon on a night that is full. You will not have to... You will not have to crowd to see him. فَقَالَ كَمَا وَالْكَافِ لِلْتَشْبِيهِ. So the person said, the kaf here is used for likening. As you will see the moon, you will see your Lord as you see the moon. The kaf is for as. وَهَذَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. This is the Messenger of Allah speaking in this manner. وَنَحْنُ مِنْ قَاعِدَتِنَا أَن نُؤْمِنَ بِمَا قَالَ الرَّسُولُ كَمَا عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ كَمَا نُؤْمِنَ بِمَا قَالَ. From our aqeedah is that we believe what the Messenger عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ said, just like we believe in what Allah said. فَأَجِيبُوا عَنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ. So they say, now give me an answer. Give me an answer to this narration that they consider to be problematic and bizarre. نقول نجيب عن هذا الحديث ومن غيره بجوابين الجواب الأول مجمل والثاني مفصل. The Shaykh said, we will answer this in two different ways. One is going to be a summary, while the other one will be detailed. One is comprehensive and one is specific. فالأول المجمل, the first one, which is the summary of nature or the comprehensive, أنه لا يمكن أن يقع تعارض بين كلام الله وكلام رسوله الذي صح عنه أبدا. First of all, يا أخي أن يا أختي, never ever is there a possibility that there will be a contradiction between the speech of Allah and authentic speech that is attributed to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. لأن الكل حق, because everything is truth. والحق لا يتعارض, and the truth does not contradict. والكل من عند الله, and all of it actually is from Allah. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى لَا يَتَنَاقَدُ. And whatever comes from Allah is never ever contradictory. Allah says in the Quran, Surah Nisa, Ayah 82, وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Had it been from other than Allah, then they would have found therein much contradiction and discrepancy and difference. فَإِنْ وَقَعَ مَا يُوهِمُ التَّعَارُضْ فِي فَهْمِكَ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ هَذَا لَيْسَ بِحَسَبِ النَّصِ. Oh, so if something that appears to be contradicting in your understanding comes to you, know that this is not as per the textual evidence, وَلَكِنْ بِاعْتِبَارِ مَا عِنْدِكَ, rather that is an issue that you have. In your understanding, they are contradictory, while in essence, they are not contradictory. So, in your understanding, يَأْجُوجُ مَأْجُوجُ cannot possibly be behind the wall until now, because Google Earth has already exposed the whole dunya to us. In your understanding, it doesn't enter your tiny mukh. For the rest of us, that's revelation, and we don't got a problem with that. Nobody got a problem. No Muslim in his right mind has a problem with that. So don't say that there's a problematic issue with the hadith, Or they're bizarre. The bizarreness and the problem is in your brain. Alright? So, and that is just, not just that fellow. Any one of us, ya akhwan and akhawat, you, me, wallah. Wallah al-azim, if you come across something that you're not understanding, accuse your brain. And I will do it anytime. I'll say, I just don't understand. I have a problem in not understanding, but I submit to Allah. I surrender to Allah. I believe in what Allah revealed. I believe what Prophet ﷺ taught. I'm an unintelligent person. My intelligence is not at the level for me to understand it. It doesn't mean that it's wrong. And this is the problem we have. When someone thinks he's so intelligent that it has to make sense to him, and if it doesn't make sense, there's a problem with it, then that's a problem right there. But people say, man, you know, he's a nice guy. Yeah, well, a nice guy is not going to take you to Jannah. أي فأنت إذا وقع التعارض عندك في نصوص الكتاب والسنة فأما لقلة العلم. If you have a problem, if there's what appears to be a contradiction among the textual evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah, this is either because of deficient knowledge that you have, إما لقلة العلم, you don't have enough knowledge, وأما لقصور الفهم, or because you have some inadequate قصور, deficiency in your understanding. وَأَمَّا لِلْتَقْصِيرِ فِي الْبَحْثِ وَتَدَبْرِ, or because you haven't done proper research and reflection. You have not investigated the matter properly. وَلَوْ بَحَثْتَ وَتَدَبَّرْتَ, had you researched and pondered and reflected, لَوَجَدْتَ أَنَّ التَّعَارُضَ الَّذِي تَوَهَّمْتَهُ لَا أَصْلَ لَهُ, you will find that that contradiction that you were visualizing that you've erected as a reality has no foundation and absolutely no basis. It will be baseless. It's nothing but some figment of your imagination. وَإِمَّا لِسُوءِ الْقَصْدِ وَالنِّيَّةِ وَاللَّهَ الْمُسْتَعَانِ. Or it could be because of a bad objective and intention. بِحَيْثُ تَسْتَعْرِضْ مَا ظَاهِرُهُ التَّعَارُضُ لِطَلَبُ التَّعَارُضُ. Meaning you present to the people what appears to be contradictory because you're looking for contradiction. You're looking for that. فَتُحْرَمْ التَّوْفِيقُ. So Allah will deprive you of success. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, ya. Allahu Akbar. فَتُحْرَمْ التَّوْفِيقُ. So you will be deprived of success. كأهل الزيغ الذين يتبعون المتشابه. Just like the people of deviation that are always looking for those ambiguous matters in the religion. People that are always trying to present to you something problematic and then leave you hanging. The Quran is preserved. يعني inshallah preserved. يعني can you write it down for me? Wallah, join my course. I have an advanced course, 100 students. Allahu Akbar. From the whole Ummah, from the Ummah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who are I don't know how many billion, 100 students, Allah gave him the success to join Mawlana Shaykh al-Kabir to understand that there's no issue with the preservation of the Quran. As for the rest of you watching my videos, sorry, I can't. But if you join my course, which is top-notch, state-of-the-art, unprecedented, cutting-edge material, where we combine for you the deen with the Western intellectual nonsense and zubala. We put them together and then we'll give you a very modern understanding that the rest of you who don't pay money to join the course will not know. Can you write down the Quran for us? Or if we give you blank pages? Not really. We can't talk about this in front of people, man. You know, this is for the specific, specialized, advanced people of knowledge, you know, me and my people. We discuss this behind closed doors, as the rest of you neophytes, sophomores, little feeble-minded, dustbin of history people. Gosh, don't talk about this. Don't talk about me either. If you got a problem with me, send me a private message, man. I would love to deal with you. Yeah, buddy. Allah la yuwaffi aduwinak. Allah yahdik yuslahak ya Shaykh. Wallah al-azim, you at'abtana. Wallah, you've troubled us and you troubled the whole ummah. You let every Tom, Dick and Harry, every Christian run his mouth from here to China because of you. Because of you. Because you think you're something special. Top student, top batikha, top batatis, top dajaja. Kullu topi tabbak ya rabbu tantabbu nikhlas minnak unaftak minnak umin waj'a dimagak waj'a rasak. Hey. Al-muhim. ويتفرع على هذا الجواب المجمل أنه يجب عليك عند الاشتباه أن ترد المشتبه إلى المحكم. Now to give you the specific detailed answer, that means that whenever you have something that appears to be ambiguous, you have to understand the ambiguous in the light of the entirely clear evidence. لأن هذا الطريق طريق الراسخين في العلم. This is the methodology of those who are grounded in knowledge. This is the methodology of those who are grounded in knowledge. Allah says in the Quran, قال الله تعالى هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات. Muted يا بابا. فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله. As نعم وما يعلم تأويله إلا الله والراسخون في العلم يقولون آمنا به كل من عند ربنا. طيب. It is he who has sent down to you the book. In it are ayat that are entirely clear. They are the foundations of the book, and others not entirely clear, meaning ambiguous. So as for those in whose hearts there's a deviation, they follow that which is not entirely clear thereof. Seeking al-fitna, polytheism and trials, and seeking for its hidden meanings, but none knows its hidden meanings save Allah. And those who are firmly grounded in knowledge say, we believe in it, all of it, meaning the clear and the unclear, is from our Lord. And none receive admonition except people or except men of understanding. ويحملون المتشابع على المحكم حتى يبقى النص كله محكما. So they always understand the unclear and the light. They interpret the unclear text in the light of the clear text so that everything becomes entirely clear. وأما الجواب المفصل. Now that was the gen, that was still actually falling under the general answer. As for the detailed answer, فَإِنَّنَا فَأَنُّجِيبَ عَنْ كُلِّ نَصٍ بِعَيْنِ فَنَقُولُ. So we will deal with each evidence independently and we say, إِنَّ قَوْلَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّكُمْ سَتَرَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ كَمَا تَرَوْنَ الْقَمَرَ لَيْلَةِ الْبَدْرِ لَا تُضَامُونَ فِي رُؤْيَتِهِ لَيْسَ تَشْبِيهًا لِلْمَرْئِي بِالْمَرْئِي. The statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is not, he is not actually making a comparison what is seen, he's not, but it is comparison between the seeing, not what is seen, but the actual seeing. لَكِنَّهُ تَشْبِيهِ لِلْرُؤْيَ بِالْرُؤْيَ. Meaning not the seeing itself, but what is being seen. تَرَوْنَ كَمَا تَرَوْنَ. You will see as you see. فَالْكَافِي كَمَا تَرَوْنَ دَاخِلْ عَلَى مَصْدَرْ مُؤَوَّلْ لِأَنَّ مَا مَصْدَرِيَّ وَتَقْدِيرُ الْكَلَامِ كَرُؤْيَتِكُمُ الْقَمَرَ لَيْلَةَ الْبَدْرِ. Meaning the same way you're able to see the moon on that night. وَحِينَئِذٍ يَكُونُ التَّشْبِيهُ لِلرُّؤْيَا بِالرُّؤْيَا لَا الْمَرْئِي بِالْمَرْئِي. So then what is intended here, the comparison is between the act of seeing and not between what is seen. The act of seeing itself, just how you see, not the object which is being seen. Meaning we're not likening Allah to the moon. Please understand, we're not likening Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the moon. We're likening, the Prophet ﷺ is likening your seeing of the moon. This is how you will see Allah. So the likening is to the act of seeing, which is very evident, very clear, and very straightforward. وَالْمُرَادُ أَنَّكُمْ تَرَوْنَ رُؤْيَةً وَاضِحَةً كَمَا تَرَوْنَ الْقَمَرَ لَيْلَةِ الْبَدْرِ. Meaning you will have this very clear vision, just like you see the moon on that, on the full night. You see the moon, the full moon on that night. ولهذا أعقبه بقوله لا تضامون في رؤيته. That's why I said you will not have to crowd to see him. أو لا تضارون في رؤيته فزال الإشكال. And so there's absolutely no confusion whatsoever anymore. Do you understand? So what the Prophet ﷺ was comparing is not Allah and the moon, rather you will see Allah just like you're able to see the moon. How clear do you see the moon? If it was if the moon on a full night, the full moon on a night. The full moon, and you're not, you don't have to crowd to see him. How easy is it for you to see the moon? It's very easy. That's how easy it would be for you to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Yawm al-Qiyamah. So you understand? When the people try to present to you these narrations and try to cast doubt, when you have knowledge, then you will have no problem. You will be able to understand everything adequately. That's why learning and understanding is the key to all of the confusions. And of course, that has to be coupled with a good intention. Otherwise, if you have the wrong intentions, then you can go astray and you can lead others astray. So we will conclude inshallah ta'ala so we can have some time for the Q&A before we deal with a very interesting hadith about Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah creating Adam in his image and what is intended by in his image. But we will leave that till the next session, bi'idhnillah Azza wa Jal. Let's see what we have here in terms of Q&A. I'm guessing some of the people answered the questions earlier. How do I get notification for live lessons and timing? Join us on One Way to Paradise. All right, there, somebody answered. I'm sorry. I want to ask you, can a wife divorce me on false information and the so-called mufti gave her the divorce? That's too technical to be answered so casually like this, man. I don't know what's going on. And I would rather not deal with those advanced topics. You require a judge. Can you make a lecture about Asha'ira? What are their beliefs in Aqeedah? I've already have. If you watch the lecture, do you really know him? Then we discussed the belief of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah, and we mentioned the Asha'ira. And this whole book is actually dealing with what the Asha'ira believe and why they have deviated. So if you go through the book, you will get it, inshallah. At-tahreef and ta'til. Bravo. Bravo, ya Sha'al. Tayyib. MashaAllah, is it possible to see Allah Azza wa Jalla in a dream? Yes, it is possible according to some. And Prophet ﷺ did see Allah Azza wa Jalla in his dream. Yes, sir. I heard Ya'juj and Ma'juj will kill everyone on earth except the people on the Mount Sinai. Will the Ya'juj and Ma'juj kill the Muslims too? Allahu A'lam. But I've given a lecture about this. It's titled The End Part 1 and The End Part 2. I've mentioned whatever narrations we have relevant to Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Okay, I don't see any more questions. Are there any on Zoom? Where do I open the chat? Here we are. Somebody asked for an explanation of the ayah, أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضِ طيب. What about it? That's a clear ayah that Allah Azza wa Jal is above the heavens. Do you feel secure that He who is above the heavens will cause the earth to fall apart and basically demolish you? أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ is one of the evidences that Allah Azza wa Jal is above His creation. It's one of the evidences we use to prove the transcendence of Allah Azza wa Jal, among many other evidences from the Qur'an and the Sunnah. And the people of deviation, they try to say that it's the angels, and they, again, that's exactly what we're discussing. They want to do tahreef of the ayah, and they want to do ta'teel of the intention of the ayah. Ta'teel, they say it cannot be that it's speaking about Allah. And tahreef, they want to distort the meaning that it's referring to angels or something else. Say, did the Sahaba give it that interpretation? If they didn't, then you have to take the apparent meaning. Hey, barakallah fiqh. Akul hal, I have a lecture titled, Where's Allah? And in that lecture, we explain this ayah in detail in the lecture itself, which you can find on YouTube. Tayyib, that's it then. Where? As a born Muslim, do one have to declare shahada if she wasn't practicing earlier? Yeah, if you were not praying and you were not practicing Islam, of course you have to enter. I mean, you have to enter into Islam again. Being born Muslim does not suffice until you, at the age of puberty, basically, you declare, obviously before that, you declare your entrance of the religion. You're not held accountable before puberty, but you still have to declare your shahada, yes. If you were not practicing or if you didn't believe in the past. If you prostrate in prayer and you prostrated accidentally, are you a disbeliever? You prostrated accidentally to someone? How in the world are you going to prostrate accidentally to someone? You tripped? I mean, if you tripped, then of course not. It's the noodles guy, oh, okay. Ya Sheikh, where do you get these questions from, Ya Sheikh? Oops, oh, I'm sorry, I just made sujood. La Sheikh. Elaborate a bit more on, as you said, one can see Allah. What? The Prophet ﷺ saw Allah Azza wa Jal in a dream. So if a person sees Allah in his dream, that's on the person. I haven't, so I cannot speak about it. If noodles, if someone is in front of you, if it's accidental, how will Allah hold you accountable for accident? رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَخِذْنَا أَن نَسِينَا وَأَخْطَأْنَا. Our Lord, do not hold us accountable if we forget or if we make a mistake. And Allah says, as in the hadith, Allah replied, فَعَلْتُ, I have done so. Meaning Allah will not hold you accountable for something you forgot or for a mistake. So just, but don't go around falling in front of people all the time and prostrating by mistake. I mean, that usually doesn't happen in a person's entire lifespan. Not even once. Not even close. So, yani, don't make it a habit. Hey. Yalla, enough inshallah. Zakum Allah khair. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Ashadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka atubu alayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.